anyone who has interacted with Sri Pranab Mukherjee, Pranabda to so many of us, comes back with a lasting impression about this remarkable man. In public life and in politics, probably my earliest deeper interactions after those with Madhavrao Sindhya were with Pranabda. It was in fact Sindhya ji who took me to him. I came back marveling at this encyclopedic intellect, blessed with an elephantine memory. I have frequently told him that politics gain was the loss of so many varied disciplines: constitutional law, the legal profession, academia, historical research, and so on. Few can rival his precise, precedent-based approach, plucking from the air an accurate anecdotal recall, which usually fits the problem at hand like a glove. Only recently, when I met him for this book release, he regaled me for over an hour with the historical evolution of West Bengal politics, greeting me as a new West Bengal member of parliament. Typically, he would make his point after rattling off precise figures of political parties' relative strengths during each assembly election, with names and facts 50 to 60 years old. Few can match his iron discipline, from his morning constitutional to his late night diary entries, with unfailing and uninterrupted continuity. Few can match his reading over diverse subjects, and even more, his eidetic memory. Since he knew my father over several decades, there could hardly be a more apposite person to release this book. His ready and warm acceptance has touched us all. We wish him many, many years, more years of productive activity in the service of the nation, from his pen, from his addresses, and from his diverse initiatives. Nitin Gadkari ji is the jolliest minister I have come across. He is a man known to cut to the chase, focused with Arjun-like obsession on the result. Never one to care too much about procedural niceties and protocol, he exudes natural warmth. Above all, he is a man of his word, and my words are pregnant with more meaning than I can reveal here at this function. I have enjoyed many historical and delightful moments in our earlier years as the triumvirate spokesperson's panel with Jaipal ji and Anand Sharma ji. And today, Anand Sharma ji leads the charge in Rajya Sabha with aplomb and gravitas. Naresh Gujral's candor quotient as an MP is very high, and I envy him for that. And he frequently speaks truth to power, fearlessly, but with research and dignity. Dinesh Trivedi and Pawan Verma are two MPs whose USP is that they are not cribbed, confined, or constricted by the narrow political boundaries of their respective political parties and speak with enviable issue-based forthrightness. Pinaki Mishra is a colleague both at the bar and in parliament, apart from being an old friend. And he is doing an interesting thing. He is adroitly managing a so-called tightrope walk, supposedly not only between the Congress and the BJP, but also qua all other third front and regional parties. That must make him and his party the most accomplished trapeze artist ever. Last but not the least, our moderator Karan Thapar, fresh from his own book release, will, I am sure, again impress you with his razor-sharp devil's advocacy. How irrepressible yet non-invasive he is remains to be seen. It is difficult to speak objectively about one's father. Some of what I had to say is in a chapter in the book written over 20 years ago, which I titled My Son's Grandfather. But few who knew Dr. L.M. Singhvi would dissent with his description as a true Renaissance man, an intellectual colossus who strode a bewildering array of diverse fields with consummate ease. He was a savant, a seer, a seeker, a thinker, and a philosopher par excellence. from leading the interfaith movement to conversing in Sanskrit. And he complained to me in the 70s that he had nobody to speak to in Sanskrit. So his Sanskrit is going bad. From being an erudite parliamentarian to a top lawyer. From an incubator of ideas as diverse as Lokpal, Panchayati Raj, Pravasi Bharati, to being their midwife. From being one of India's most successful ambassadors ever, to being a recognized Hindi poet. From being a great orator, to being a gentle soul. LM Singhvi was truly a man of many parts, each of which he fulfilled to perfection. He presided as High Commissioner in UK during the golden period of Indo-UK relations. He saw 3 British Prime Ministers and 5 Indian Prime Ministers in his 7 years there. He reached out to the diaspora there. His correspondence with Prince Charles over 10 years, and I presented those 19 letters of Prince Charles, all handwritten ones, to Prince Charles this summer in June personally, shows the width and depth of their shared interests. It spans the interfaith movement, Jain temple architecture, A Tale of 3 Cities, which is my father's title, linking Vivekananda to Chicago, the World Human Rights Conference at Vienna, and the Environment Colloquium at Rio, and many more landmarks. Ladies and gentlemen, may I end by thanking my co-editor, Lokendra Malik, the publishers, Oxford University Press, for ensuring that the delivery of the book was swift, painless, and on time. As is well known, books are a joy to conceive, but painful to deliver. Efficient midwifery by these two has resulted in what I hope will prove to be a bonny baby. Thank you.